Good morning, students. This is Mrs. Uma Maheshwari from Sir Isaac Newton School. I'm handling English for 6th CBSE. Today we are going to see a poem. A house, a home. Okay. Before we enter into the poem, let me know some details about what is poem. A poem may be written on any topic. Okay. Whether it may be a plants or animals or life or a person or nature, whatever it may be, okay. A poem can also convey a message. Through a poem also we can able to convey a message. It is used to help us think about or reflect on the particular topic or feeling, okay. So what is the purpose of poem? A poem can also convey a message. It is used to help us think about or reflect on particular topic or a feeling. Okay. Usually lines in the poems end with words that rhyme. Okay. You know what is rhyming? The end of the poem is same. That is called rhyming. That's why we said the rhyme, nursery rhymes. Okay. Not poem. In the same way, poems also, there are one or two stanzas are there. Every poem is divided into stanzas, okay? In a passage, otherwise in a prose, we used to say 4 or 5 lines togetherly, it's a paragraph. But not in a poem. Poem, we should not use the word paragraphs, okay? Instead of that, we have to use stanzas, okay? In this poem also, we have two stanzas. So in a poem we use the word stanza, not a paragraph. Okay, shall we move to the poem? Yeah. What's the topic? A house, a home. What's the difference between house and a home? So these are all the things we are going to see in this poem. Before entering to the poem, let us know something about the author. Lorraine M. Halley is the author. Okay. Lorraine M means Martha. So that's a female poet. She is an American poet. She was born on December 8, 1921. Okay. Her writing style is very simple yet thought-provoking, which means a strong idea she has. Okay. This is something about the details of the author. Author, which is nothing but a writer. Okay. And then, shall we move to the poem? Okay. What is a house? The first sentence is, first line is, what is a house? It's bricks and stone and wood that's hard. Some window glasses in perhaps a yard. It's eaves and chimneys and tile floors and stucco and roof and lots of doors. So in this first answer, she described about house. What is house? House is nothing but full of bricks and stones. Yes, if you want to construct a house, we need bricks to build the walls and construct a house too. And wood that hard, yes, we need hard woods. So for what purpose? To make the doors and window doors. For these purpose, we need wood. And also, some window glasses. Yes, we are using glasses. Nowadays, we have varieties of glasses and glass paintings are there to decorate the windows. And perhaps a yard. What is yard? Yard, which is nothing but courtyard, which means veranda. Okay, so we have verandas in our home, in our house, not a home. It's eaves and eaves, E-A-V-E-S, eaves. A part of the roof, okay, that the end at the roof, that is join the floors. That is called eaves and chimneys. You know chimneys, nowadays we have modern kitchens. In that modern kitchen also we have chimneys. In foreign countries also in their living room they have chimneys for giving warm purpose, because that is in a winter season they have too cold, so they need chimneys there. And tile floors, I don't need to say something about tiles. You know, nowadays we have colorful and varieties of tiles to decorate the floor. Am I right? Yes. And stucco and roof. What is stucco? Which is nothing but a plaster. Okay. a paste, just like a paste made of cement and sand to cover the wall. Okay, to that finishing work, we used to say, you know, that is okay, that's called stucco. And a roof, you know very well, roofs and lots of doors. Yes, each and every rooms we have doors. We have so many rooms in our house, that is a living room, dining room, kitchen, bedroom, puja room. So for each and every rooms we have doors. So and so many designs are there, works are there. So we need lots of doors. So according to these things, what did you know? So house, which is nothing but a construction, okay, a non-living material only, okay. The things, the costliest thing we are using to make a house. Why we are spending thus much of amount to build a house? Comparing to other things, for a house, we are using, spending much money, and we are decorating our house in a different ways. Am I right? Why is it important? Why, what makes us to build a house in a luxurious way, otherwise make us to spend this much of cost to make this house? We will get an answer from the next stanza. Okay, what is a home? What's the second stanza for us? What is a home? It's loving and family. Okay, what is home? Loving and family, and doing for others. What we are doing for others, that is home. Okay, it's brothers and sisters and fathers and mothers. It's unselfish act. Okay, so not only the peoples, those who are living in the house, with the kind-hearted, unselfish act. Okay, we have to kind with your family members, and we have to have some kind of bondage with them. What bondage is that? That is love and affection. See, always our mother is ready to prepare a food, otherwise for everything what we need. Am I right? Without any expectation, she won't expect anything from us except our loving and affection. Am I right? So that is called an unselfish act, and that things make the house into home. So the affection, the love, the transactions, okay, we are sharing our feelings and emotions and works, everything with a smiling face. That is called a home, okay, a kindly sharing and showing your loved ones. You are always caring, okay? Somebody's caring you, and also you care somebody's health. Sometimes, suppose your mother is not well, you said, Ma, you take rest, and you ask your mother and you worry about your mother. Am I right? So whether it may be mother or a brother, so any persons in your home, if they are not well, definitely you felt so bad, and mentally you were upset too. So what makes that? The affection makes that, okay. These kind of affections alone make the house to a home. So you make your house a home with your love and affection in your family. Thank you, students. I hope you enjoy this poem. I enjoy a lot. So you enjoy this poem. If you have any doubts, ask me individually. I'll clarify with it. Thank you very much.